Does everyone feel these videos are very dynamic, powerful, and captivating after watching them? Today I'll continue showing you how to make this kind of epic, highly dynamic videos and become an AI video maker professional, and you can do it using only your home low VRAM PC. Completely free, and free to use. You may ask, there are many powerful paid tools online that produce high quality. Why bother using a home PC? I think there are two reasons. First, it's free, convenient, and uncensored. Running on a home PC can feel a bit slow, but it can run completely hands-off. Once you set up the commands, let it run during idle time, and you can do other things, very low maintenance. Second, running AI on a local PC can protect your privacy. You don't need to upload any personal data to the internet. At the end of the episode, I'll also provide a more professional workflow that lets you run with a few simple settings, run hands-off, and get finer results. I'll also share the latest fast video, 4K upscaling techniques that support low VRAM. If you find this useful, please support my Patreon, buy me a coffee, thank you. How do we make these videos? First, you should install Comfy UI, Triton Windows, and Sage Attention. You can refer to my previous video or my Patreon for detailed instructions. I won't go into detail here. There are several core challenges. The first is how to make the character correctly pick up a weapon as we want. The second is changing camera angles. The third is how to add more detail to the video. Remember these. I'll give the best solutions for each shortly. First, we need to generate scene images for each storyboard frame. This uses image editing models such as Quen Image Edit 2509 or Flux Context. I use Quen Image Edit 2509 because I find it a bit more powerful personally. We can generate characters and weapons with image generation tools, choosing whatever looks good to you. Next, we need the character to pick up the weapon. If you just write a prompt like, have the character pick up the weapon and generate, it may work sometimes, but often it's a matter of luck and you may need many attempts to get the result you want. How to increase the success rate? Here are some tricks. First tip, raise CFG to 2 or 3 to strengthen the prompt adherence, but do not exceed 3, otherwise image quality may drop. When AI generates images, it balances your prompt and its internal scene understanding. Higher CFG makes the model try harder to follow your prompt and pack in all details, but overexerting can make images unnatural, distorted, or noisy. Second tip, have the character pose first, then pick up the weapon. Let the AI work step by step. This greatly increases success and matches how many AI agents operate now. You can draw a rough sketch of the pose or import an accurate pose image to greatly improve precision. How to prepare pose images? You can take selfies or photos of others, then extract the pose skeleton using OpenPose and feed the skeleton image as a reference into Quen Image Edit 2509. Then, we need camera cuts. For quick camera switching, we can use the recently released camera switching LoRa, Quen Edit 2509. Multiple angles, it's very convenient. Download it from Hugging Face. After downloading, put it in Comfy UI, Models, LoRas. Note you must restart Comfy UI to see it. In the workflow, use LoRa Loader to load it. The prompts are simple. Its commands include, move the camera forward. Move the camera left. Move the camera right. Move the camera down. And so on. Load the image you want to change and tweak the prompt. It generates very easily. Convenient, right? Sometimes certain dynamic actions are hard for Quen Image Edit 2509 to understand. For example, the action of shooting an arrow is difficult for it to generate. In that case, we use WAN 2.2 to generate video first. Yes, we generate a video with WAN 2.2, then extract suitable frames from the video to use as keyframe images. After the video is generated, we can use this workflow group to extract our keyframes. The video's result may not be exactly what we want, but remember, we only need to extract the keyframes. We repeat this method to produce all the keyframes. Finally, we convert the images back into a video using WAN 2.2. We use the FLMF node for this. It allows WAN 2.2 to generate a video based on a start frame and an end frame. We'll also use the WAN Video NAG node to improve video stability. To increase dynamism, you can crop keyframes from generated images, change the angle, and use them as end nodes to create more motion. Note, Cropped keyframes may be a bit blurry. To improve quality, enhance details first, with Quen or Flux. You can refer to the workflow I previously published. It can be found on my Patreon. After rendering the segments, stitch them together, add sound effects, adjust timing, and you'll have a finished video. If you enjoyed the episode, please like, subscribe, and share. I've prepared a more professional workflow on Patreon that runs with a few simple settings, is low maintenance, yields finer results, and includes the latest fast video to 4K techniques that support low VRAM. If you'd like that, please support my Patreon and buy me a coffee. Thank you.